Digo Telecom completes its fifth annual technical audit. The findings by an independent auditor were confirmed by the telco regulator. It's the last of such audit under Dito's commitment period, in which it pledged 84% coverage of the national population and minimum average broadband speed of 55 Mbps. The actual results, 86.3% coverage with minimum average speeds of 92 Mbps for 4G network and 597 Mbps for 5G. Next, the Philippine National Bank. It confirmed plans for a dollar bond offering by the fourth quarter. The banking arm of the Lusitan Group said this is part of its strategy to manage upcoming bond maturities and raise funds for its initiatives. That bond offering, though, would still depend on the market outlook and PNB's balance sheet needs. Finally, to the House of Tog, the real estate developer is acquiring a new property in Rizal Province from another listed firm, Liberty Flor Mills. The parcels of land cover 372 square meters with contract price at 1 billion pesos. House of Tog pays up 10 million pesos upon a deal signing with installment payments in the next 2 years. Rice importers warned against holding their rice shipments in Philippine ports. The Agriculture Department issued this warning amid reports nearly 900 containers holding nearly 500,000 sacks of rice are currently waiting for release in Philippine ports. The rice importers allegedly waiting for rice prices to rise before selling. The DA asserts this practice is illegal.
Posibleng ano to eh, maging hoarding na tinatawag kasi merong mga ilan, meron ng mga 9 months na dyan. Apparently, nitong mga consignee na ito, they want to wait para mas mataas ang presyo ng bigas para lalong lumaki yung kita nila. So hindi tama yon, and that may constitute sa hoarding or may iba pang kaso na pwedeng ipataw sa kanila.
The Philippine Ports Regulator, meanwhile, seeks greater role from importers on handling rice shipments. The agency on Friday reiterated its position that port congestion is not to blame for higher prices of the staple grain. The Ports Authority also said it was in touch with Agriculture Chief Francisco Chu Laurel Jr. to clarify the issue.
Yan din po ang suggestion po namin sa Department of Agriculture na magkaroon po sila ng dagdag pong obligasyon o responsibilidad ng may hawak po ng import permit na kapag yan po ay na-clear ng Bureau of Customs o ng BIR, na sa loob lamang po ng 5 araw ay mailabas na po kaagad yan sa pantalan po at ma-distribute na po sa merkado. Wala pong kinalaman yung port congestion. Kung kinukulang man po ang supply ng bigas sa merkado o mataas ang presyo ng bigas sa merkado.
The Sugar Regulatory Administration has increased import clearance fees for high fructose corn syrup. From the current 1 peso and 50 centavo fee per bag of sugar, it has been raised to 30 pesos. This in a bid to curb the use of artificial sweeteners. SRA Administrator Pablo Ascona said the increase of import clearance fees was unanimously passed by the Sugar Board last month.